Hey guys, Steph Mischuk with killerphp.com. In this video blog, I want to give you a quick little programming and web design tip. And that tip is, strive to make your code understandable and legible from the point of view of a programmer or designer coming back later, looking at your code base 6 months later, 3 months later, or a year later. So that's well spaced out, well laid out, so it's easy to follow and read. This is opposed to making your code compact, maybe a little faster in terms of load times. And this is the general rule that you have to use going forward. Now, you may not have considered this, but in the recent past even, and I think probably still today, people are still thinking about writing code that's more optimized. So let me give you an example in a web page, just basic web design. So it goes outside of PHP. Well, it goes in PHP. Up until several years ago, and to be honest, I haven't followed what the people are talking about nowadays. You had a lot of these web standard zealots who didn't come from coding from a programmatic background. They were designer types, web designers, and they started trying to raise the bar, which is admirable, in terms of how they structured code and how code had to be correct and so on in the web page. In my opinion, they went a little bit too crazy in that they went, in terms of being, that the code had to be semantically correct. And if you couldn't, you had to use the right tags. It had to be absolutely, correct in a particular application as opposed to maybe being practical. Now, I'm not going to get into this in detail because that's not the point of my video. So with these web standards guys, one of the big things that they would do is they would say, listen, you should write very compact code where they would actually use tools to eliminate white space between lines of code so it would compress more. So by doing this, they would argue that you could remove a couple kilobytes from the download of the web page. That's true, because you'd have a little less white space in the page. But the problem is your code would be all squished together, so it'd be much more difficult to edit and to understand what's going on later on. Another thing they would do is they would argue about CSS and how CSS should be used in a certain way. I'm not going to get into it. Again, to optimize the code for speed. It sounds great, but my problem with this is that, my big argument back in the day was that, we were getting into the whole YouTube generation where everybody's downloading video and audio. So it's like, to be concerned about 10 extra kilobytes or 20 extra kilobytes of a download on a page is silly when people are downloading, video. Video is, of course, much, much heavier. This today has become even more pronounced because, we're in the day of HD video download. So it's like to be concerned about 20-30K extra in your web page and to spend all kinds of extra time to compress your page a bit more, to make it a little bit smaller so that it downloads a little bit quicker because there's less K, is silly. Because at the end of the day, everybody's going on high-speed internet, and it's just going to get faster and faster and faster as they go forward. The other argument people would use is, well, yeah, but if your pagers are smaller, then you use less bandwidth, and you have a big site that's popular, and it's going to cost you less than bandwidth. Well, that's also true, too, for the top 100 sites in the world. They may be concerned about that. For the 99.99999% of people, it's not an issue. Bandwidth, your allocated bandwidth, even on the cheapest hosting program, is so cheap now, and it just keeps getting cheaper and cheaper every year. A figure I heard was that bandwidth, it decreases in cost by 50% per year. Even if it's half that, 25% a year. To start spending all kinds of extra time to optimize code to save on bandwidth when the cost of bandwidth is just dropping into the, like a stone, there's no point. It's a waste of time. The cost in time to do all these optimizations is in my opinion, is wasted time and wasted money. So when it comes to HTML, CSS, don't try to compress your code. Don't try to do anything that would inhibit your ability to write clean code that's legible later on. Now, I'm not saying you shouldn't use server gzip compression. If you don't know about this, servers, most web servers, just about all web servers, they have this gzip compression technology where the server will compress your pages and then send it out to the web browser, and then the web browser decompresses it. So it's smaller, and it makes it a touch faster. But you don't have to worry about that. Your server administrators will have that configured. When it comes to PHP, and programming in general, let's take a look back prior to PHP. Now, if you look back in the early days of programming, well, not so early, but the late mid to late 90s, people had to write really optimized code, programming code, because the hardware simply was pretty wimpy back then. You know, I remember I got into it in the early 90s, and I had 500 meg hard drive and 2 gigs of RAM, and I was the king. I had the most powerful computer. And in those days, people were also running on very wimpy modems, 2800 baud modems, and I think 28k a second, something like that. It's very slow. So you had to really optimize at that time. You had to optimize your code because people had limited RAM and limited hard drive space, so everything had to be really tight. So let's look at programming specifically. Let's look at function names, for instance. Now, with function names, in the old days, they used to write very terse, meaning short, function names. Reason why they wanted to, again, if you have 500 functions or 5,000 functions and they're all very long names, it's slower to process, So the old computers had you'd see a difference. So you would write very terse names, a function A, or function B, or function biz count, something like that. So, and you had to do it at that time because, again, computers were wimpy. Things have changed today. Computers are super powerful now. So as a result of that, and they just keep getting more powerful every year. So as a result of that, what you should be doing is optimizing your code for readability, for editability, as opposed to speed. Now you optimize in terms of how you write and structure the code. In terms of optimizing your functions and your algorithms so they're faster, that's a different thing, and you should do that. But in terms of if you're going to sacrifice readability of the code to optimize it for a kilobyte size or something, that's the wrong way to do it. You want to go for self-describing functions and variable names. So let me give you an example. So if I had a function that sent an email, in the old days they might go email and then the other function. And then that would be the function, would be called email. Now, if I had an email class or function, we'll say function, and it was sending email specifically to clients, I would call the function client, send client email. It's kind of long, it's verbose, but it tells you exactly what the function does. So I don't have to think about it. Email, it tells you, okay, it's sending email, but is there any specific thing about that email class? For instance, let's do something a little bit more realistic. Maybe you have a function where you're inserting database records for new users. So I would maybe call that function insert, database, insert new user, something like that. That way, it's pretty clear what the function is doing. Again, it's a little longer to type, but I'm telling you, months later, or even years later sometimes, when you have a clear set of function or class names or variable names tell you exactly what's going on like that in the actual names themselves, you're going to thank yourself for having done that. So there you go. I meandered a little bit here and there, But what to take away is you want to write code that's self-describing. You want to write code that's easy to update later on, so it's clearly structured. You don't want to start trying to compress the code and trying to make it more optimized in terms of download times, because simply we live in the video web video age that's irrelevant nowadays. And that's pretty much it. I hope you liked the video, and we'll talk soon.